Oh, a neighborhood. I will talk about
common house.
I said that our topic tonight is about health, astaghfirullah.
Yes, common health.
Common health. Yeah. Oh, yeah. My birthday is now at 9. Later, after this. Okay, I think we can start for the last class. I mean, because tomorrow it will be an evaluation class. So today we are going to talk about health. This one. Okay, these are common health complaints in the world. According to the National Center for Health, the common health in the world are headache, backache, sore muscles, stomach ache, cold, cough, flu, and insomnia. These are common health in the world. So maybe I'd like to ask you, Mr. Peter,
yes, sir.
Which complaint, with health complaint, do you have you had recently?
About insomnia.
Insomnia. Why? How could it be? How could it happen to you?
Yes, because this insomnia sometimes connected my activity on the ship. Sometimes at sea, come a bit water, too much wind. Mm-hmm. Sometimes cannot to sleep in the good. Tidak bisa tidur dengan nyenyak.
Sleep well.
Yes, because about this bad weather and sometimes 2 days, 3 days continue. Insomnia, maybe coming.
How many hours do you sleep on the ship?
Working sometimes 4 hours after working, we have 8 hours for rest, but sometimes insomnia come. Did not sleep and working again.
So how do you solve your problem? Because I think you will be sleepy when you were working.
Sometimes too much eating maybe and drink a vitamin and. Sport with my friends in very little time. After that, go to rest.
Okay, so yeah, because I think insomnia is one of a difficult health complaint to be cured. Because yeah, you need. So is it because? So how about when you are in the land? Do you feel insomnia too?
No.
So it's happened only on the.
Sometimes this bad weather coming, then insomnia coming because I cannot sleep inside.
Oh. So I think it's terrible for you to sleep on the sea, yeah, in the ship of wave, sometimes is unpredictable, right? Does the wave can be predicted? Can the wave be predicted?
Yes. Yes. Sometimes I predict it. I drink vitamin and I drink maybe too much heat about vegetable, about yang banyak mengandung serat about fruit about eating fruit sport activity.
Okay. So I think it's really terrible. How about you, Mr. Diki? Which health complaint do you feel recently?
Recently
is akhir-akhir ini.
Okay. Alhamdulillah, Mr. Mujib, I'm fine. No complaint. Alhamdulillah, I healthy. Yes.
Okay. So it's really good if you are always healthy. If you are getting sick, what will you do for the first time?
No special activity, because maybe I clean my home, so my children playing, so no special activity to first, pertama awal run the morning.
Okay, do you have family doctor?
No, Mr. Mujib. I don't have a family doctor.
Do you think it is important?
I'm sorry?
Do you think it is important having a family doctor?
I don't understand.
Do you think it is important to have family doctor?
No.
Why not?
I to doctor because I sick. If I'm not sick, I not go to family doctor.
You don't go to the doctor. Okay.
Yeah. Okay.
You don't go to the doctor. Okay, so okay, thank you, Mr. Diki.
Thank you, Mr. Mujib.
Just a beginning. Just start slowly. So how about you, Mr. Badawi?
Okay, Mr. Mujib.
What health problem you have had recently?
I had cervicals. In the past.
Okay.
I don't remember.
So What do you do? What did you do for your health? Your sick. What do you do? What did you do to cure your sick last time? Yeah.
Because too much work. Too much work.
So, what did you do to cure it?
I drank my painkiller. Painkiller, obat. Painkiller.
Medicine.
I drink a medicine, yeah. Obat.
Oh, is it Dr. Recep, or you only buy the out in the apothecary, or you buy in the market?
Buy in the market.
Oh, buy in the market. Don't ask Recep from the doctor.
Yeah.
Okay. Yeah. Okay. Do you think buy medicine in the market is a good way to cure our health complaint? Or should we always ask doctor when we get a sick?
Because they had it's good because they had expire yet.
Oh, okay. Thank you. Oh, so you just see from the expired date for the medicine.
Yes.
Okay. Thank you. Maybe I'll move to Mr. Firman. Mr. Firman, should we always ask to the doctor when we are getting sick? Hello, Mr. Firman.
Mut.
Sorry. Ah. Sorry, Mr. Musib. we must not asking to doctor because today is very much information that can we have from internet, maybe example from Halo Dokter, maybe, or like a symptom sick before, may it's like a cough and breathing and maybe hot, yeah. So if we do not need to ask to doctor, Mr. Mujib.
Okay, so we don't need to ask. We know that nowadays there are platform like Hello Doc as a platform to help us when we are getting sick, and then we can complain there. So does it really help us?
Yes, it's very really help us to fix about to make our body to make a decision about what the medicine we should to buy, or just counseling to doctor maybe can help us to overcome the sick. Mr. Mujib.
Okay. So, thank you, Mr. Firman. Maybe I'll move to Mr. Oktu. Mr. Oktu, the symptom of coronavirus is almost same with the normal cough or headache, and then sometimes they get fever. So, how how do you believe in yourself when you get cough, and it was not a symptom of coronavirus?
Okay, honestly, today I'm not well. I feel hot, my body is coming. And my opinion is 50-50. Is I believe 50%, I cannot believe 50%, because there are person don't have apa itu namanya, OTG?
Symptom.
Yes.
Gejala itu symptoms.
Yes, I don't have symptom, and several is have symptom like that. Yes, I think my opinion, that is my Mr. Mujib.
Okay, so in this pandemic, how do you keep your health? How do you keep your healthy for you yourself and your family? How do you maintain the health of your family?
Okay, for myself and my family, I give they apa itu pengarahan apa ya?
Guidance
to avoid virus attack corona. We have to use a mask and often hand washing every time, everywhere where we go. And then I do a little sport, so I do like a gym or jogging around my house, and then avoid it to junk food, because junk food has a lot of cholesterol, and maybe virus can easy attack my body because too many not good substance for my health, I think.
Okay. Thank you, Mr. Abdul. Mr. Isradi.
Yes.
Do you agree if happiness brings our body health, brings our body health or increase our immunity?
Yes, I agree. Because if we always happy, our thinking, our brain will be positive thinking, and then it is will be what's strength our immune.
Yes. So it will strengthen our immune. Okay, our immunity. And recently the bioscope, the cinema will be open. So because of that reason, so do you agree of that? Do you agree with that?
No. I for now I don't agree. Because our government make a rule to make a distance, social distance. And then if we in cinema, we will be what's the udara apa ya?
The air
in the cinema is not good for we.
So
this is same like if we go with using plane. I don't agree. We using plane for more than 2 hours or more than 2 hours, because the cyclos air in the plane is not good for our healthy, I think. Even using mask. I think that.
Okay. Okay, so it's interesting. Miss Lely, because you are a mother, and then I think children are difficult to be handled because sometimes children they want to play and then with a dirty things, and then in this pandemic, how do you guide your children in order they know to wash their hand and then use hand sanitizer and then using a mask? How do you trigger them to do that?
Okay, thank you, Mr. What I do in this pandemic area for my children is, of course, I will give some guidance, guidance, but also I will show many videos about this virus, the effect of this virus, and the videos of the standard of operation, standard of operation while living while in the pandemic area. And also memantau. What is memantau?
Control.
Okay, yeah. And of course I will control them when they will go outside.
Yeah, and then okay, I know that Sidoarjo is one of the red zone, or yes, but now orange, yeah, orange.
Yeah, today zone. Is going orange.
Today is going orange, but recently it was red. So, how do you restrict the activity of your children? Because I think they like playing, and then they are bored to staying at home.
Yeah. In the first period of pandemic, we really restrict. We really do, what is that? Berdiam diri di rumah itu. We really do PSBB.
Stay at home.
Oh yeah. Stay at home for about 3 weeks. Mm-hmm. But after that, because of boring, I give a chance to my children to play outside. Of course, they have to do the SOP and give limit time. For instance, in the morning, I allow them to go outside because there are sunrise. They have play outside, not inside the home in the morning. And in the afternoon, I also give a right to them to play outside, playing football or others. But the most important thing is they have to do SOP, the standardized in this pandemic area.
Okay, it's good parenting, I think. Okay, so, thank you everyone. And I'll move to the next. I think it's the vocabulary, the simple vocabulary for acknowledgement. Yeah, this one. So normal vocabulary. I think you know all that.
Sunburn.
Sunburn itu kulit terbakar.
Not sunburn. Heartburn. Apa serangan jantung, Dai?
Serangan jantung.
Heartburn. Heartburn.
Heartburn.
Sunburn.
Sunburn, kulit terbakar.
Terbakar. Sunburn.
Rash.
Terbakar.
Rash. Rash memar.
And irritation.
Sorry.
And irish.
Irish, mana irish?
Irish.
Oh, oh ini sakit. Sakit telinga. Sakit telinga.
How do you pronounce? How do you pronounce H aja aja itu? How do you pronounce it?
Oh, backache, backache, headache. Berarti earache, earache, earache,
earache.
Toothache. Ada. There are two people. There are two kind of pronoun. People, some people said, you Australian say backache, but American say the headache. Some people headache. Che, they say che. Sometimes some people say ke, headache. But sometimes some people say headache, headache or headache. Stomach ache. Stomach ache. But the common is a stomach ache. Stomach ache, headache, earache, earache, toothache.
Memar.
Memar, a rash.
Oh yeah, rash memar. Rash memar. Sorry, heartburn. Astagfirullah. Heartburn itu bukan sakit jantung, saya baru ingat.
Hati.
Heartburn itu mah.
Heartburn. Bukan serangan jantung.
Bukan.
Oh, kalau serangan jantung heart attack ya.
Heart attack. Kalau serangan jantung itu heart attack.
Heart attack, serangan jantung.
Heart attack. Kalau heartburn itu mah. Misles itu apa ya? Cacar. Enggak salah iya cacar. Ha, misles itu cacar.
What's misles cacar. Campak.
Campak.
Mils campak.
Campaknya susah.
Oke.
Okay. Campaknya susah.
Okay, cramps the cramp. I think that's the vocabulary, simple vocabulary, and it's just a conversation. Ini mungkin saya lewat karena ini biasanya saya pakai kalau misalnya sama anak-anak kecil. Student junior high school, or I will use it. This is conversation for, okay, I will explain the grammatical first before we are come back to the speaking. Okay, we use sometimes, we can use can, could, and may for request and suggestion. So, ketika teman-teman mau menggunakan request ataupun sebagai permohonan, you can say, you can use can, could, or may. Can I have a box of cough drops? Can I have something for a cough? May I have a bottle of aspirin? So, it can be request. Penggunaan can, may, atau could itu bisa digunakan sebagai request. Dan juga bisa digunakan sebagai suggestion atau saran. You could try this lotion. You should get some skin cream. Why don't you try this ointment? Ointment, do you know ointment?
No.
Ointment is salep.
Oh, salep.
Ointment is salep.
Not cream.
Ikan suang.
No, not cream. Ointment. The kind of ointment, there is a cream, liquid. So that's the kind of ointment. But kalau untuk salep di English is cream. Cream itu lebih for our body. Okay, and this one function of can, could, and may. Ketika teman-teman menggunakan dalam speaking, can itu bisa digunakan sebagai offer, menawarkan, permission, izin, ability, kemampuan, possibility, kemungkinan, and request. So, fungsinya ada offer, permission, ability, possibility, and request. Can I be of any help? You can put offer there. You can put offer there. I can drive a car. She can be really sad. Ini kan possibility. Dia mungkin, artinya ini bukan bisa, tapi mungkin sedih. Can you be quiet? Request. Apakah kamu bisa diam? So does cold. Cold juga punya fungsi suggestion, permission, ability, possibility, and request. So we could write a letter to the president. Or could I ask you personal questions? So how about my, may, we can use possibility. Kalau if the possibility is higher, I mean that we guess it, it will be possible, so we can say may. She may be at home. Kemungkinan, ketika kemungkinannya tinggi, berarti kita pakainya may. Tapi kalau cuma kira-kira lah 50-50, use can or could. Permission. We can ask permission, sama. May I sit here? Permission give possibility. You may go now. Maksudnya permission di sini meminta dan memberikan izin. Request juga sama. Kalau permintaannya yang mungkin diperbolehkan, kita pakainya may. May I have the bill please? Kalau yang ini kan, can you be quiet? Ini kemungkinannya bisa rendah. Maksudnya mau yang diminta diam belum tentu diam, tapi kalau ini pasti dikasih bill-nya gitu. So we can use may, or may juga bisa digunakan sebuah harapan. May I have the bill please? Means that bolehkah, apakah saya dapat. So it has the same meaning, tapi fungsinya akan berbeda. Okay, and then so I think I'm going to start for the.
Okay.
I'm going to start. I want to ask your opinion about this. Mm-hmm. Okay, now I ask you, what do you think about health system in Indonesia and what should government do to make it more better? I want to know your opinion. What do you think about health system in Indonesia and what should government do to make it better? Ini gak ada more-nya ya, sorry. To make it better. Oh, ada Miss Miftah, saya baru sadar. Okay. Firstly, I start from Miss Miftah. What do you think about the health system in Indonesia and what should government do to make it better?
Sorry, sir. I newcomer. Maybe the other person more first.
Yeah. Okay. Okay, I'll start from Mr. Diki.
Okay. Okay. I think health system in Indonesia is better because Indonesia have BPJS, so all people
can go can to hospital can to hospital
maybe
yeah I think not for all to memenuhi ya to memenuhi
fulfill
to apa keinginan ya keinginan itu apa
wants needs
wins.
People wants people needs people needs
kebutuhan ya yes to people needs Indonesia yes so yeah government must give to all people a big to probat apa hai probat apa to
come to the doctor to cure
yeah to doctor all penyakit ya all
illness disease disease
yes maybe Mr. Mujib
uh-huh. Okay so so you means that government should cover all diseases that yes. Get by the citizen okay so okay Mr. Diki said the government the system health system in Indonesia is that is good so how about your opinion Mr. Okto
I think my opinion is not good but it's not bad because sorry it's not good but it's but it's good too in Indonesia have BPJS but we have to pay for get apa kesehatan ya mendapatkan kesehatan
get facility hospitality
yes get facility we must to pay it for get facility and for should government make I think in government West Java different with government in Jakarta. Government in Jakarta given more apa itu sembako apa ya a more facility about healthy something like hotel what's it asrama COVID in Jakarta
COVID dormitory asrama dormitory
yes and then I look my alone the people in Jakarta often apa ya diberikan sumbangan gitu bantuan diberikan bantuan oleh by governor but okay. different in my governor in West Java tidak apa ya not melihat secara langsung itu live kebijakan dari my governor like that Mr. Mujib
okay so that's So what should government do to make it better, Mr. Otto?
I think too many people have fired in West Java. So my government looking the people need more apa itu bantuan need more
assistance.
Yes, I think the people need more bantuan from government. Yeah, I think that's it. Okay, my so, opinion, Mister.
Okay, thank you very much, Mister.
Okay, Mister Mujib.
Okay, how about you, Mister Badawi? Yeah, Mister Badawi.
Yes. Can I? Government Indonesia, yeah, concern more professional doctor or specialist doctor, yeah, and enough regulation consistent for healthy society, yes.
Okay, so what should government do to because one of the case is the doctor are not equivalent between one place into other place. So how to make it equivalent the number of doctor in Indonesia?
The regulation first.
Mm-hmm. Okay. Mm-hmm. Okay. Which regulation do you mean? Which regulation?
About medicine, doctor, specialist doctor, mm-hmm. and rumah sakit ya. Hospital facility.
Okay, so we the government should care of it. So because the number maybe it because of the facility, because we are a big country and then we live in different area and then the logistics are difficult. So my question, Mr. Badawi, what should we do to shorten the logistic loading? Yeah, because the problem, one of the problem is logistic loading. Permasalahannya adalah di pengiriman barang for facility hospital. For hospital out of the Java, they are difficult to get facility. So how to solve that problem, according to your opinion? Bagaimana untuk mengatasi masalah tersebut? Logistic loading.
Oh yeah, distribution medicine is problem. Mm-hmm. Is problem, yeah. Apa? Dari pemerintah pusat ya. Government central government to society in di daerah itu apa ya? Regional.
Di regional,
interregional. Regional government. Okay, Mr. Masjid.
Okay. Thank you, Mr. Badawi.
I'm sorry, I'm live here.
Oh yeah, okay, it's okay. Okay, sir. Okay. So it's interesting, Mr. Badawi said that one of problem is distribution of medicine, and then the the equivalent or the equivalent number of doctor. So I want to ask to Ms. Lily, how do we make it certain for the distribution or logistic loading for a medicine?
Mr. Lily washing hand first.
Oh, Mr. Lily washing hand. Okay, so I think I change to Mr. Isradi.
Yeah.
What should government do to make it logistic loading, especially for medicine, faster?
Oh, okay. I want to explain about ratio doctor first.
Mm-hmm. Mr. Okay.
The ratio of doctor in Indonesia is one doctor for 250. 2,500 people.
Wow, it's big, man.
So the best on WHO is one doctor is 500. And then is the meaning ratio doctor in Indonesia satu berbanding lima ya, harusnya apa?
One per five.
One for five, yes. This is not good, right? And then about what you're asking? I forget.
Okay, how to solve problem logistic loading problem for medicine?
For medicine, yeah. I think send medicine to the patient must be fast. Yes. And problem our country or our
regulation policy.
Policy and hospital usually the patient must be payful for the medicine. This is hospital or apothec. Not give a medicine to the patient. Yes. Health system in Indonesia, I think this is a good. And then a system logistic medicine in Indonesia is good too. I think that's Ms. Mujib.
Okay. So I'll move to Mr. Firman. Mr. Firman, we know that to cover our insurance, health insurance, we maybe pay BPJS card, but will BPJS exist till the future, or is just one of the program that will be bankrupt and then change into other program? So what's your opinion about that?
Okay. Mr. Rojib, my opinion about BPJS is starting from Susilo Bambang Yudhoyono policy and exists until now. And I believe the BPJS will exist for the next policy, maybe the new president is still continuing this policy, Mr. Mujib, because this is very important for people, for Indonesian people, as to guarantee of healthy system. And the healthy system in Indonesia is guaranteed by the law. Diwujudkan apa ya? RAPBN.
Okay.
The system education and military is more than 20% for RAPBN, Mr. Mujib.
Okay. Yeah, Yeah, we know. Yeah, that's yeah, BPJS. I think it's still continuing till the new president or like I don't know. But but if we can see, or recently our president was, I think that he is confused or he is anger to the Ministry of Health. The Ministry of Health. Then my questions: the Ministry of Health work well in this pandemic?
If we say so seriously about our policy, about our government policy in all sector, especially in health system. It's look like government is not seriously to cover all the health system, because we know we see that the focus of government now is infrastructure, so that all of the model of nation is focused to infrastructure. Mr. Mujib, maybe.
So we focus on infrastructure. Yeah, because yeah, it's really tough for our country. We have many problems, especially for health or something.
Like a debt trap, and do you know the debt trap? We must pay the debt for luar negeri,
we have a debt trap to United. Yeah, it's not United. World Bank. We have a World Bank, right?
Okay.
Yeah. Okay. Maybe I'll move to Miss Lily. Miss Lily, in this, especially West Java. I think the governor of West Java, they Ridwan Kamil, try to to be a volunteer of a vaccine that produced by by China, because Russia before China released the vaccine, Russia has released the vaccine and it was failed.
Mr. Mujib, loss.
Loss.
Loss kontak.
Berarti di bahasa aja, bos.
Ini vocab.
Ngopi dulu, ngopi.
Kopi.
Ini kopi Toraja.
Sama.
Toraja kopi.
Ini makanan nih. Okay,
Mr. Diki. What's your opinion about Wisma Atlet? The ambulance was queue to entrance Wisma Atlet.
Queue entrance? I don't know lah. I follow about news for COVID recently.
I watched a viral video from SOSMED. Many ambulance queue to enter Wisma Atlet. This the meaning patient of COVID-19 is so much and high in Jakarta.
Yeah, maybe maybe my people like that Mr. Octu say 50 believe or 50 not believe.
Believe or not.
Believe or not.
Yes. It's true, Mr. Andika.
Do you hear like the Jakarta that's about COVID-19?
Yes, Luram Ruya. Luram Ruya in the campus that COVID.
Okay.
Ruya Selatan. So Meruya.
That's the meaning many people that's cause virus. COVID virus. COVID-19. Yeah. Yeah. Okay. You must believe it that the virus is any in Indonesia.
Back to Mr. Mujib.
Okay.
Sorry, I lost my signal. I don't know why it is off directly. And yeah, maybe I'll back to Miss Riley last time. I talk about vaccine. So should we, what is that? Should we wait for vaccine or be back to our activity normally? Because economic is important, but health is more important. We cannot live without money, but we need the money for life. But if we wait for a vaccine until the last of trial, I think it will be on the middle of 2021. And my question, maybe it will be on 2021 according to prediction. So my question, which one should we, which one is should be our priority for that? Should we wait for vaccine and then we back to the activity normally, or we back to activity normally right now?
Do our activity normally first while waiting the vaccine.
Hello, Miss Lily. Oh, is my voice?
Hello. Can you?
Yeah. Okay. I sorry. Can you repeat, because I don't.
Oh yeah. What we should do is do our activity normally while waiting the vaccine coming.
So our people, especially in the big city like Sidoarjo or Surabaya, they resistant to what's that? Yeah, to be attacked by the virus. So I want to ask about the policy in Sidoarjo or Surabaya about COVID-19. Do you know well about it?
Not really.
Maybe you can explain me a little about that.
For nowadays, we get, what is that, mass operation, and they have to pay at least 150 to 250 if they forbid not wearing the mask. This is the nowadays policy.
Okay, then is there any night hour?
No.
No, okay. So people who sell food and it's like micro business, they can sell food into midnight.
Yeah.
Oh, 24 hours.
Yeah.
Okay.
It only happened when it was PSBB, midnight hour. But now in Sidoarjo, there is no PSBB again.
Okay. Maybe I will know. Our health system, our problem in our country is not only about virus, but we have like malaria and then stunting, because the number of stunting is increasing, or especially in this pandemic. So, how do you? What's your opinion about the stunting in our country?
What is stunting? I don't know.
Do you know stunting?
No.
Stunting is kekurangan gizi.
Oh. Stunting.
Can you repeat once more?
Lapar. Usung lapar.
I have just known the meaning of stunting. So what is your question?
My question is, what's your opinion about the problem, the stunting in Indonesia? I mean, that has it covered well by the government? Has government a care aware of it?
Actually, there is no perfect system, but I appreciate of the development of the health system. And I think the government have tried to do the best for solving the stunting, such as, I don't know, it is once a month or twice a month, the government control balita.
Toddler, balita itu toddler.
Toddler. Through posyandu program. And it is run well in my residence. Posyandu run well, so that the toddler terpantau
control.
The toddler controlled well by government.
So is controlled well by government? Because I don't know. Because you live in residence, it's really different compared with the remote area, like in the west, maybe in the east area, like Timor or Papua, or even in my Hampton. Yeah, there are many babies, there are many toddler, they get stunting because they are lack of nutrition. The lack of nutrient. Even in Purwokerto, in Banyumas, there are many child get stunting because they don't get any nutrition. They don't get full nutrition with nutrition for their growth age, because it is the golden age, right? So the golden is for the children, but when they don't get supply for nutritious food, they will get stunting.
Does posyandu program run well at Purwokerto?
The posyandu in the central of Purwokerto, it run well. But if we move to in the marginal area, it doesn't run well. When I was in organization, I focus on that, so I know the case of stunting in Banyumas or even in in Central Java, because we always discuss with the association of it. Okay. And then, how about, because you live in residence, my question, how about the common health complaint that happened in the in near your area?
For older or for
For older generation. Or still old generation or
For children, they get flu, fever. It always happen, and adult for adult only they get backache. And for the other cholesterol such as heart attack.
Okay, I think I'll move to Mr. Peter. Yeah, thank you, Miss Lily. Okay, Mr. Peter. Yeah, I think because you live, most of your life is in the sea. My question, is there any facility of health in the ship?
Yes, sir. In the ship, I have a facility, but only this low facility, only prevention about medicine, about pasuntikan. Sometime accident in the ship. I have certification because on the studies in university before this lecture try how about if any accident in the ship such as fire accident such as falling in stairway sometimes maybe stomach, sometimes head much. I take number one prevention is how about this action as apa korbannya?
Advice.
How about the victim action with menangani korban? Itu yang this number one. Number two, sometimes my ship in the port. Recently and quickly report to the office, report the port control and bring the going to the hospital. But sometimes in the ship, only is how about apa menjaga dan merawat.
Okay.
Yeah. Only this try out this menangani keadaan seperti itu sampai dapat pelabuhan.
Okay. So you so how about several months ago, I think in the beginning of the beginning of 2020, there is a case that crew of ship died and then they are thrown into the sea in the it's Indonesian crew of a ship. So does that practice happens when there is a crew died in the sea and the ship and then they will be thrown into the sea? Wow.
Yes. Sometimes this any crew dead in the sea. Sometimes thrown in the sea. Sometimes not. If the man is dead. About the virus, about the apa virus menular. This maybe corona that she, but call his family, is agree or not? Call the company agree or not? But I have a law of international about maritime. It's no problem. Grounded if any crew death in the sea, it's no problem because I have law of international about it.
Wow! So it's really hard to live to live in the sea because when you die, our family will not know us when if we die in the in the middle of sea. Okay. Thank you very much. You can go on. Go on. Maybe we still have time.
Several mon ago, this a debate in the Indonesian people about the one of the crew from Indonesia in working in China Sea, grounded in the sea in the Pacific Ocean, and this man from South Sulawesi, and near and my home, this my junior school. But I think this no problem about this. Only people are not understanding about the law of the sea.
Okay, because it is agreement between the crew and the company.
No. Okay. But sometimes they say that is accident cannot grow with the sea.
Oh yeah.
Sometimes because sometimes this criminal cannot grow to the sea, but sometimes. That is because the virus is can grow in the sea.
If the crew died because of virus, so they will be thrown into the sea.
Yes, because not thrown into the sea, maybe apa minura.
Oh yeah, I see. Okay, I think that all the crew died, they will be thrown into the sea.
Yes. Sir.
Okay, so it's really tough, I think. Okay, I think the last Ms. Miftah. Ms. Miftah, maybe I'll back to the my question for the beginning questions is about the health system in Indonesia, especially in your area. Where are you from, Ms. Miftah?
I'm in Bekasi.
Yeah, okay. How about the health system in Bekasi? Do government control well? Do government give facility well into the citizen?
My opinion, the system in my area is pretty good. It's true that what Mr. Diki said is BPJS. It's just that in the process, BPJS participant have to fill out a long list, and it takes time and the handling. But my friend didn't immediately experience it. In different, when the line is self contained, fast handling is handled. Maybe different times. In the hospital is different. I think yes, if you use BPJS, maybe need a long time and no fast handle. But if I self assurance, maybe so it's so fast handle like that.
Okay, so the problem is in the response, how fast the response of management of hospital when they use BPJS?
When I use BPJS, I must to take a number, and numbers so many, maybe one until 30. But if I self, I will life number one.
You will be priority.
Yes, the priority.
Okay. Yeah. Yeah. Because it is self insurance, and then self insurance pay more than. So how about the hospitality between state hospital and private hospital in Bekasi? How about the hospitality there?
Hospitality? What you mean, sir? I'm sorry.
Hospitality means that fasilitas and fasilitas dan pelayanan. Hospitality.
Oh, I think is I feel the hospitality it's good because 2 years ago, berobat? I go to the hospital. Uh-huh. And using BPJS and the service and hospitality is good. Like maybe what is that? To meet doctor and apa? Kalau di ronsen? It's yeah, ronsen. Maybe in the lesnya adalah apa? Need a long time. Just it.
Okay, need a long time. Okay. Okay, I see. Okay, thank you, Miss Miftah.
Yes, sir.
Thank you. Okay, yeah, thank you. Thank you very much for all. Maybe I will give a correction. Some correction first. Tadi ada yang bilang nothing complain. Just say no complain. I have no complain. Bukan I have nothing complain. I have told you that no itu kalau emang ada sesuatu ada bendanya langsung aja no complain. Then we mustn't come. I think dilarang itu bukan tidak harus itu doesn't pakainya need to. Nah, kalau mustn't artinya nanti dilarang. We mustn't come, kita dilarang datang. Kan tadi kalau sepemahaman saya tadi kalau nggak salah Mr. Firman yang bilang kita tidak harus, we don't need to. Nah, pakainya need to bukan mustn't. Mustn't itu artinya dilarang. Kalau tidak harus kita pakainya adalah need. Jadi must itu harus, tapi kalau jadi negatif jadi artinya bukan tidak harus tapi dilarang. We don't need to. Then, yeah, some of you are still use model auxiliary, tapi masih pakai to. We should to, we can to, tadi we could to, itu to-nya dihilangkan. Gak usah pakai to. Maybe it's habit, so you can that. Okay. Then using because when you said because. If after because as a sentence, maka teman-teman pakainya because. Tapi kalau setelahnya adalah phrase atau cuma kata, pakainya adalah because of. Misalnya, because of too many people. Tadi kan ada yang bilang, because too many people. Yang benar adalah because of too many people. Nah, pakainya because of. Tapi kalau because, kalau teman-teman karena, cuma karena setelahnya adalah kalimat lagi, pakainya because. Because I want to go to market. Because I need a treatment to go to hospital. Now, tapi kalau misalnya because of the doctor, because of the hospitality, because of, nah itu cukup, kalau setelahnya frase atau kata, pakainya because of. Oh ya, yeah. Tadi Mr. Isradi kalau nggak salah yang bilang our brain will our mindset. I think our mind, bukan our brain.
Okay, thank you.
Terus Mr. Oktu kalau nggak salah tadi yang saya masih ingat yang bilang live tadi kalau nggak salah langsung bukan live itu sepak bola kalau live kayak pertandingan. Directly.
Directly.
Okay.
Live streaming.
live streaming. Oke, okay. I think that's that I got. Jadi yang masih tambahan buat teman-teman adalah tadi no, so you don't need to nothing complain, no complain, just directly. Ya, kemudian modal. Kalau modal jangan usah pakai to, jadi bukan must to, just must, bla bla bla, should, bla bla bla, langsung ke kalimatnya, nggak usah pakai to. Tadi yang sering
nothing,
salah.
Nothing penggunaannya bagaimana?
Nothing itu misalnya contoh gini, tidak ada apapun. Saya tidak mendapatkan apapun. I get nothing. Nah, tapi kalau misalnya saya tidak mendapatkan uang sepeser pun, I get no money. Nah, itu beda lagi. Nah, kalau ada benda yang dimaksudkan, kita langsung no money. I didn't get any money. I didn't, kalau misalnya saya tidak mendapatkan apapun, I didn't get anything, atau I get nothing. Nothing itu untuk kalimat positif, kalau anything itu kalimat negatif. Jadi misalnya, I get nothing. Nah, tapi kalau pakainya anything, berarti I don't get anything. Kalau nothing, berarti kalau misalnya ada bendanya, I met no one, sama saja no one, nobody. Misalnya saya tidak bertemu siapa-siapa, saya tidak bertemu siapapun. I meet no one. I didn't meet. I met no one. I didn't meet anyone. I met anybody and nobody. I didn't meet anybody. Ya gitu. Jadi kalau misalnya langsung, kalau ada bendanya ya berarti nggak usah pakai nothing lagi. Bukan I get nothing money. I get no money. I get I have no girlfriend. Bukan I have nobody girlfriend. I have no girlfriend. I have no money. I have no car. Misalnya, simple like that. Jadi penggunaannya seperti itu. Okay, I think that's for tonight and tomorrow. It will be the evaluation night, so it will be like last week. So you should present about I will give you questions and then you have to answer. Everyone will get different topic. It will be like last week. Okay, I think that's all, everyone. Thank you very much for your time and see you again tomorrow.
Bye-bye. Thank you very much, Mr. Mujib.
Okay.
Thank you, Mr.
Okay.
Assalamualaikum.
Assalamualaikum.